as we reflected on it, there are really 10 areas that are basic. Certainly nothing terribly brilliant, but they seem to get lost in the shuffle when you are going through an experience like we have.
A shuffle refers to a mix where different elements in a situation get mixed in together, and where sometimes things that are pretty important, they tend to get forgotten because they're in the middle of other things. So if something is lost in the shuffle, that means that it's something that is presumed to be important, but which unfortunately got forgotten. And so now it becomes important to start to pay attention to that thing again.
And shuffle comes from the cards, from the game of cards, correct?
Shuffle comes from playing cards, yes, where there's 52 cards, but you may have one card that is more important than the other. So if you want to play that card, you should have that card available. But if it gets lost in the shuffle, you may not have it when you need it.
And you shuffle cards before you deal them, right? Which means you mix them up?
You mix up the cards, yes. When I joined the army, I thought I was going to get assigned to Europe, but somehow my paperwork got lost in the shuffle and I ended up in Antarctica. Too many children that are at risk get lost in the shuffle and they never get the help they need to be able to improve.
Our culture puts a premium on things like quality and empowerment, results, diversity, fairness, customer, corporate responsibility, things.
A premium refers to something where you place a high value on that thing. For example, if a company puts a premium on loyalty, it means that they value the quality of loyalty over other qualities that are also good qualities to have. Another company may put a premium on intelligence or industry competence or whatever it is they feel is important for them.
Right, so they value, they emphasize, they consider very important.
Exactly, and they use that one quality is a guideline for a lot of the other qualities. For example, a sports team may put a premium on speed. So they don't want to hire anybody that's slow, even if they're otherwise a very good player.
Okay, and if someone is hiring for a job, then you can say that they put premium on the experience, not academic credentials.
That's correct.
And premium can also be used as an adjective. You can have a premium product, right?
Yes, you can have a premium product. A premium product would be a product where people pay more for the product to get the high quality of the product. So for example, the iPhone 6 is considered to be a premium product. It may cost two or three times more than other similar products, but it's so much better that people are willing to pay a premium price for it.
Or a company, if you get the service or product, let's say you get an air ticket from a company, they will offer you a range of prices from standard to maybe, you know, higher range price, which would be called a different name, but it's going to be a premium service. They will offer additional service, maybe better food, better seat, more spacious seat. So it's going to be a premium service, and you have to pay a premium price.
That's correct. And a lot of people, wealthy people, will prefer to pay the premium for premium service, because they know that they're getting extra things that other people simply aren't getting, which they will find to be a value to them. in some industries, experience is at a premium because the industries are so new, it's difficult to find people with industry experience. Steve Jobs put a premium on thinness and sleekness of design for all of the Apple products because he had an interest in Zen Buddhism and simplicity, and he wanted his products to reflect his sensibilities. ESL-FullSteamAhead.com